Before we take the questions, I'll just give the last 5 minutes talk, and then we can probably move on to the questions. I just want to highlight some things about the society called the Young Ophthalmologist Society of India. So this, we have been working since last 2 years on this. Most of the team members, the people who have been here have been very active, and because of them we have been able to move ahead. So we started 2 years back. We thought that there was a need for a society that would cater to the young ophthalmologists, that can work on some limitations that are in the other societies, which do not the management is not a part, the young ophthalmologists are not a part, so they do not know that what are the needs. So we started this, and this is a website www.biosi.in on which we started the activities. And the first activity we started was creating a Facebook page. And the best thing we got out of it was that we started learning from each other. We posted our cases, and there was a discussion. How much?
5 minutes.
That's fine. I'll just take 2 minutes. So we started learning from each other by posting cases. There are some seniors, YOs also, like the people awarded in the fellowships. We started helping each other, asking about the examination procedure, about these, which machine to buy. So these were our concerns which we had, and it was easily solved over there. Encouraging each other, sharing our achievements with each other, because that is, we encourage each other, then only we can move ahead. Keeping each other updated about various new innovations, new techniques, new conferences. So we make it a point to keep regularly updated all the bios. We have now more than 1500 members in the last 2 years. So there's no registration. This is basically the first thing when it was creating a Facebook page. The people who are into it are already a member of the society. Also, because I found that a lot of bios are not member of any society, like they were not members of AIMS as they recently joined, they're not a member of Delhi society, so they didn't come to know about various other conferences that were being held even in their own cities. So because this is a freely available platform, so we could share all the courses, all the programs that were being held, sharing what career opportunities, if there was any job position that was there near any place, you could post here, other people could know. After we found that it got a good response, we started with other roles for our society, which included the first one was the YO Times. It was an official publication of our society. This magazine was started 2 years back. Now we already down 8 issues of the magazine. This was the first issue which launched, these are the subsequent 6 issues, and now another 8 issues also come. We found a team which had a total board with the people who worked on the issue, and we had reviewers like Dr. Digvijay himself, and who could see the articles, with the content of the articles, whether it was right or whether it needed a modification or whether it could not be taken. These included articles which pertain to the bios, like the residents' diaries, like sharing their own experiences. So Dr. Mohit also wrote an article where he shared his fellowship experiences. We had other fellowship experiences from other people, then about learning surgeries. We had some interview with experts where we talked to them about how they climbed the ladder to the top and how what challenges they faced as they were bios. So this was quite interesting. Then apart from these, we had some special guest editorial where we had encouragement from a lot of top people. They told us about life, about how to perceive and how to have a work-life balance. This was an interesting thing. We had some research-related articles. We always keep our issue on the research so that the academic knowledge of our community keeps on growing. So how to read a scientific paper, how to do analysis. We have a course. Then we also collaborated with other societies such as the European societies, the American societies. Next, we introduced this YO Center, in which what we did is all the free journals, all the free presentations, supposedly anybody who is willing to like give his presentation and doesn't mind sharing, we all put all those presentations and books on this YO Center. It's a Dropbox application, very simple. You just have to go on the YOSI website, click on YO Center, and you will have access to all the free non-copyright material which is available on the net. So from last 2 years, whatever our team could find, any material which is genuine, which is good, and which is available freely, we put it on YO Center. Next, we started the YO Assist. This is myself during my post-graduation and during my initial years of senior institute, always found difficulty in getting free articles from journals. They all almost all are paid. Even the DOS and the AIS give limited access to few journals. So I found like, why should when my friends who are sitting in America, they don't have any problem in access to any journal. They are easily writing papers one after the other, whereas we are always having this problem. So we started BIO Assist. In this, if you mail your query, this you can go on to the BIO and check the email. You mail any paper you want, you just mail to BIO Assist. Within 24 to 48 hours, you will get the paper, full paper through this BIO Assist. That is because we have collaborated with few people who are give generous academic grants for just for this purpose. So they sent to us, I sent to them, and within 48 hours they were directly sent to you. So this was the BioAssist, not only on publications but also on collaboration. We call BioAssist was to collaborate with other agencies, like for your marketing initiatives, or marketing, your video editing, your presentation modification. So anything you require, we collaborate with a lot of associations. Even we started an EMR, electronic medical record system. We gave a 1 year free trial to all the BioAssist members. Also started the BioSocial, in which we thought that when we have such a large community and we are on Facebook, why not spread awareness to the people through our own page. So started the BioSocial, which was spreading awareness for better eye care. We keep on putting posts which are shared by a lot of people. So the idea is to just spread awareness in your own groups. We got recognized by the European societies, American societies. We started bio sessions in almost all the conferences. We started from the DOS, then we went on to the AIMS, we did in Jaipur, and now this session is again a part of that. But we found that the sessions are limited, maybe, and we cannot plan it as we want. So we started our own meet, which was the first year by surgeon meet that held last year, was attended by the full house, and it was thoroughly appreciated by all the guys, because the program was very much as per what they wanted. So I just want to say that never let go of your dreams, and we are as a society, our plan is to help in as many activities as we can for the bios, and so that you can all achieve whatever you feel is your dream. Thank you so much.